Hi, this is Madduma. These are instructions on how to download and install Vortex for Fallout 76. First, you're going to want to go to NexusMods.com. Click the Install Vortex link at the top. Click to download the latest version now. Select the Vortex download you want. The instructions in this video cover the default Vortex download that will install the program in the C drive. Run the program, it will install Vortex. Up at the top right, you'll see error messages from Vortex. Always pay attention to those, they're very helpful. This one says that Vortex will now handle Nexus links, which means that when you hit download with Mod Manager, it will download to Vortex by default. First thing you'll want to do is sign into Nexus Mods. And now I'm signed into Nexus Mods in Vortex. This is the main dashboard. Should also give you some important prompts. Gopher released a series of videos that go through Vortex and its various features. I'll link those below. There's also a link within Vortex in the tutorials button. But for this, the first thing we're going to do is enable advanced mode in settings. That will give us the extensions button on the left. Then you're going to download Fallout 76 support from the Nexus main page. The link is below. And just a reminder, always endorse files that you use and that work as expected. I also track them on the Nexus page for my own reference, because the tracking within Vortex isn't always 100% correct. So you're going to drag and drop the download into the extensions drop files at the bottom. Find Fallout 76 on the list. I'm sorting by mod author to pull it up to the top, and just make sure it's enabled, and then restart Vortex following the prompt at the top. Now you have installed Fallout 76 support. So the next thing you're going to want to do is add Fallout 76 through the Games button on the left. Check in Discover to see if it's already there. If not, go to Supported. Click Manually Set Location. Navigate to your Fallout 76 install. Select the folder. Now it will be in Discovered. Click Manage. And then it will now show up in the Supported menu. If you have more than one game, you may need to click Activate here. You'll see on the left that mods appear. What I like to do is track any files that I've downloaded from Nexus for a specific game in the mods. So I'm drag and dropping the Fallout 76 support into the mods section. Then I'm clicking Never Installed to install the archive into Vortex. This is how you would install any kind of mod in Vortex. If you want to see the metadata for the mod, you'll double click the mod and it'll come up on the right. Then you can edit that metadata. What I'm showing you here is how you can link the Nexus page for the mod to your mod. Notice that for this particular mod, because it's on the Nexus mod section of the website, you have to change the drop down to say Nexus Mods instead of Fallout 76. Then when you click the link at the bottom, it should pull up the page for that specific mod. I'm also adding the version here in the archive. It's always to the right of the Nexus mod ID. Now I'll show you what happens when you enable a mod. First, I'm going to pull up the data folder for Fallout 76 from the open button at the top. And I will show you in a side-by-side that when you enable it, first you're going to get a request to elevate. If you have the game installed in a UAC directory, in this case it's installed in program files 86. Once you elevate it, you should see that the files appear in the data folder. Obviously, for Fallout 76 support, we don't want it to be installed. So I go to the drop down to the right, click on Open in File Manager, and delete the contents of the folder just so that there's a dummy folder so that I can watch for updates. So that's an overview on how to install Vortex for Fallout 76. Thank you so much for watching. Also, thank you to Tannen and the Vortex team for developing a great mod manager, and wxMichael for uploading the extension, and also the modders out there that have put up some excellent mods. Happy nuking!